our farm is the Grand Forks office. We dubbed this project Warming a Child. We purchased a variety of patterns, both boy and girl appropriate. Then our group came together on two separate occasions and formed an assembly line type of cutting and tying the fleece. 13 of the blankets were donated to Lutheran Social Services Healthy Families. Amanda Jimenez came out to headquarters for the presentation of blankets and also informed us of her agency, which provides free voluntary home visitation services to support overburdened expectant parents. 14 of the blankets were donated to Grand Forks County Social Services Foster Care Program. Wayne Pache came out to headquarters for the presentation of blankets and to also update us and educate our office on the increasing demand of foster care for our area. This is the second year that Black Gold has donated fleece blankets to the Grand Forks County Social Services Foster Care Program. The transportation team started this program as part of their 2012 giving back. Still note, I dare say that every employee in the Grand Forks headquarters building participated in this event.
Hello, I'm Clint from Louisiana, farm manager for at Oak Grove Black Gold Farm location. Our give back program consisted of primarily raising money for the American Cancer Society through the Relay for Life program. Our Sweet Potato Festival in the spring of the year raised probably $3,000 total. We had a good time doing it. We also gave to public figures, and we sent a young man to Boys State in Louisiana. If we were chosen for the $1,000, we would probably just give that to the American Cancer Society.
2013 Giving Back Project for the Red River Valley have offered to help Forest River and the School of Midway, whatever they need. But one thing I found as I started in Harvest is there's a lot of needs within our own group. What I came up with is the Giving Tree program. The month of November, we've been putting in nominations of needs of either friends, relatives, or our own staff, just to give them a helping hand for the holiday season. Due then is now going forward until about December 15th, is will be those needs are been placed on a tree, and people that come into the plant are able to take one of the ornaments, I guess, that we put on the tree that have the need. They can purchase that, and then we'll make sure that gets to whoever has been nominated. I'd like to continue this, not only just on the holiday season, but throughout the year as people have needs. So it's a giving tree that keeps on giving, I guess.
The executive team participated in an afternoon of volunteering at the St. Joseph Food Pantry in Grand Forks. We sorted through boxes of donated groceries, separating the canned items from bagged or boxed goods, while also looking for outdated items. We would like to see this small effort become an ongoing project for anyone in the Grand Forks area willing to donate a few hours of time. The food shelf is always in need of volunteers. St. Joseph's also operates a thrift store, as well as the food pantry in Grand Forks, and the piles of donated clothes and groceries can be overwhelming. Any funds received as a result of our work for the food pantry will be donated to them to help families in need of food or clothing during this Christmas season.